Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. The investigation continues into a crash in Kensington that left two men dead and a third fighting for his life. The crash happened Tuesday night on 108. Police say this Toyota 4Runner crossed the center line, hit some mailboxes and then trees before flipping over at least twice. 21-year-old Malachi Davis and 21-year-old Hunter Vars both died at the scene. 20-year-old Jack Perro was airlifted to Boston, where at last check he was in critical condition. State police are investigating a fiery crash on I-89 in Enfield that left one person dead. State police, they were called to southbound side of the highway near exit 16 just after 4 o'clock yesterday. Troopers and bystanders tried to save the driver, but the flames were too intense. The driver's name has not yet been released. A convicted murderer is asking a judge to let him out of prison early. Eric Winhurst pled guilty in 2005 to killing Daniel Paquette back in 1985. He agreed to a minimum 15-year sentence, but now he wants to get out about 5 years early. His attorney says Winhurst is not a threat to the community and has worked to improve himself. The state has 30 days to file an objection to the request. The Zika virus has officially arrived in New Hampshire for the first time. State health officials confirmed that a Granite State woman contracted the virus after having sex with her male partner who had traveled to the country where mosquitoes are spreading Zika. The good news is that officials say she is not pregnant, has already completely recovered, and poses no threat to others. Our latest WMUR Granite State poll is revealing how Granite Staters feel about the idea of recreational marijuana. 62% of those surveyed say they support legalizing marijuana for recreational use. More than 70% of those polled say that if recreational marijuana is ever legalized in the Granite State, they would support selling it at a licensed retail outlet and taxing it. And that's it for your morning webcast. We'll be back on the air today at noon.